Today we thought of discussing on this particular topic, which is of your resource and the queue management. In the system. So how exactly this resource on the queue management works effectively in terms of the from the EWM side. So basically, when we are talking about this resource management or maybe the queue management ideally, this has a major role in terms of the operating the warehouses indeed, in terms of the put away behavior or could be an outbound or whatever it is. But however, when we try to have a kind of so if you're able to see this normally we will have this, we will call it as an RF devices. Okay, basically where we will use it in all the warehouses, but it could be of a different companies, where we will have exactly the same replica of whatever we see it in an SAP screens, the same thing we would be seeing in the RF UI screens. So basically this is a part of your these devices, the RF devices, whatever we are seeing it here, because most of the operations when we try to perform your put away, or maybe when you try to perform your picking, any kind of an activities, it's not only a put away or whatever it is, all sort of your warehouse activities basically will be performed in this RF devices. However, this RF device configuration, I'll put it in a separate session, and how to configure it and what kind of and things that we need to consider, that I'll take it up in a different session. But this particular thing, whatever we were discussing it here, it is something which we will be performing in a transaction called as RF UI. Okay, so this is how you will be able to see your any kind of an operations. If you want to perform your inbound operations, okay, or if you want to perform your outbound operations, so all these kind of things, whatever we have, your outbound process or your inbound process, everything that you see it here will be performed by using this particular RF devices. So that is being connected through our IPS services. That's a basis activity. However, but upon we perform the connectivity and other stuff, as I said, that I'll be discussing it in the later part, not in this today's session. Okay. But the very first thing what we need to understand here is, till now, if you see this, we have discussed like how we will be performing the put aways from this particular door, or how we will be performing, or you're picking it. Basically, if you see this, from this particular door, we will be putting it in a staging areas, and from a staging areas, we will be performing this through some of the forklift devices or whatever it is. How does a person know that this process needs to be assigned? For example, because resources, in the sense, it could be anything in your warehouse, whether it could be your forklift devices, or it could be a manual worker, or it could be anything that falls under your resources, basically. Okay. However, how do we assign? Because, for instance, if you have 100 warehouse persons, okay, who are working in a warehouse, and how do we allocate the work equally to all these guys? Because we need to even also see the work should be equally distributed to all the persons. Okay, like a 50 persons who are, or maybe a 25 people, okay, should be allocated in the inbound area, and another 50 people, or whoever is there, should be allocated to an outbound area. Okay, depending upon the business, and another 25 people, we would like to assign them to for performing some internal operations. Okay, so how do we assign this particular resources, like whoever the resources, the manual physical workers, how do we assign them, and what kind of the management that we have to perform to them to make sure that these people are not been overloaded even when they are performing their inbound or an outbound or maybe internal process, any kind of this process, we need to check it. So Indeed. So here there are few things that we need to understand here. So the very first thing is the resources. Means basically resources are something, it is either your any kind of the task, I mean like any kind of an activity which are involved in your warehouse tasks basically. That we call it as an resources basically. Okay. So it could be a resource, could be anything, means in terms of it could be a warehouse person, or it could be your forklift drive, the machine which is performing some activity in an high rack storage type. So all these kind of the activities, whoever are getting involved for the creation or maybe for the warehouse putaways or anything, those kind of an activities or those kind of the things that we will call it as the resources in the EWM system basically. Okay, so as simple as that, a resource is nothing but it's an entity within your warehouse which performs any kind of a work by executing the warehouse task. So it could be a person who can go and he can put it up, so he is one of the resource. Or it could be a forklift device, okay, where it helps you to perform this. So all these things are something where we will be helping them to perform or to create the warehouse tasks. But how do we manage these persons in order to flow? Because if you are having 100 inbound deliveries getting created in your system, and how do you know that these products needs to be prioritized first and the other products for the other delivery needs to be prioritized? So that is something where with the help of the queue management, we will try to make use of these resources and then we will try to execute them in the system. Basically, when we are trying to perform any kind of an operations in your warehouse, it is most of the time we will be performing by using this RF device only, because we will not be taking your desktop or your laptop to any.